to everyone and welcome to Aquatica. By the way, my name is Marco, but meet my friend. She's the eldest female South American sea lion we have here, and her name is none other than Isis. How are you, Mario?
And my name is Trini, and he is my Italy student and very smart friend, Jenny! Hello, everybody!
Okay, now let's continue. So folks, do you have any idea why they are called fin or feather-footed marine mammals? Any idea? Do they have feathers? You ladies, do you have one?
No.
Well, actually, it's because of their front flippers, which are shaped like a bird's wing. The term pinniped may also be translated as wing-footed, since the flipper do look somewhat like wings. In fact, sea lion appear to be flying underwater as they swim from place to place. My face? Yes.
Well,
there it is. And that's a fine demonstration. How about another round of applause for Isis and Annie? And you know what? We have is long and flexible necks. How flexible? Well, check this out. Well, that's not easy. So how about another round of applause for Isis and Annie? Their body is covered with a thin coat of short, coarse hair. Their whiskers help the sea lion's sense of touch. It contains their fibers, which make them sensitive. Nice smile, Yenny and Isis. They also use their whiskers to aid in navigation and to detect vibration from prey in the water. And their small external ears give them a good sense of hearing, both above and below the water surface. Sea lion, like many marine mammals, can see well both above and underwater. They have a keen eyesight, but no color vision.
So in the wild, they inhabit waters close to shore. They have rocky cliffs, deep dive pools, and have a preference for rocky beaches. They have excellent diving abilities. It's an easy to detail rocky cliffs.
Well, they have a strong more cliffs. That's great.